I didn't want to be too obvious, but I wanted to revisit playing with this pen. This one here, and it doesn't look like much. You know, this thing is a really incredible writer. This is a great pen. And this isn't even my main jam. Like, I don't live here. I don't live in, you know, Waterman's 100-year 1940s pens. I just don't. It's not my place. But I'll tell you, when you get a great nib, great ink, great stuff. Zoom out a bit. Okay. Let's be realistic about this. You know, let's not be silly. Now, all right, so this is a hybrid, right? So there's something here. There's a whole thing about the feel of these old pens. It's not, you know, people talk about how can we get more vintage-like responses in our modern pens? How can we make these things real now? What a great pen. What a great pen. You know, and we can actually just practice with this right now. And just, like, not even mean a thing. Just simply feel a thing. Just live a thing. I'll just play this right now. This is a, what do you call this? It's what I did a while ago. Yeah, this pen is sick. This is very cool. I mean, look at this. Yeah, look at this hairline thing. Like, I can't even quite get this right, right? His hairlines are so cool. This is crazy. I mean, this isn't even my period. Like, you know me. I'm all about the 20s. This is so 40s. This is so big time World War II. Crazy. Like, that's not me. I'm all World War I. Thank you.